In the WhenToWork system, both managers and employees can set up email and text notifications. Manager notifications will keep a manager apprised of any activity the entire account, whereas employee notifications will simply let the employees know about changes to their own shifts and schedules. In a manager login, you go to Settings and you can choose the My Notifications tab. Here, you'll see a list of notifications you've already set up. In the Email section, you can click Edit to edit your email notifications. You can select notifications such as Forward My WhenToWork Messages, so that any message sent to your WhenToWork inbox will also go to your email. You can forward new bulletin board posts and billing reminders so that you are always aware when your account needs attention. You can send notifications when an employee posts a shift to the trade board, or trades or picks up a shift, requests time off, or changes their preferences. You can also have notifications sent when another manager publishes a schedule, unpublishes a schedule, edits a published shift, adds, deletes, or edits an employee, approves or denies a trade request, approves or denies a time off request, creates a time off entry in the system without the employees having submitted a time off request, or whenever another manager changes an employee's preferences, changes global employee permissions, or sends an urgent text alert. When you check off these notifications, our system will notify you at your email address whenever these things happen. You also have the option to use your email address as a reply to address. This way, whenever your WhenToWork messages are forwarded to employees and other managers, the recipients will be able to click reply and have the reply sent directly to your email address. The reply will not show up in your WhenToWork inbox. If you would like to receive all your replies in your WhenToWork inbox, do not use your email address as a reply to. But instead, require the recipient to log in and use our messaging system. When you've set your notifications as you'd like them, click Save. You can add as many email addresses into the account as you'd like. You can also add text addresses. Come down to the text section and click Add Text. Now, a text message address looks just like an email address. It includes your phone number at your provider's text address domain. Now, this can vary by provider, and the best way to figure it out is to go ahead and text message yourself at your email address. This will send a message to your email, and in the From field, the sender will be identified as your telephone's text address. It should look something like this. Once again, you'll select your notifications, and these are the same notifications available to you in the email section. The difference is that when the system knows that it's being sent to a text address, the message will be truncated. Because messages sent to text have a character limit imposed by your cell phone provider. When you click Save, a 4-digit validation code will be sent to your cell phone. You'll need to enter that code in this field and click Validate in order to successfully set up your text address. Setting up notifications for an employee is very similar. When they log in to the employee interface, they can go to Change My Information. Here, they also have a button that says Edit Email, Text, and Notifications. If they click here, they get a window just like the manager window, in which they can add both email and text addresses in exactly the same way as the manager accounts. Employee notifications are very similar. They also have the option to use their email address as a reply to address when WhenToWork messages are forwarded. Employees' notifications include Forward My WhenToWork Messages, Forward New Bulletin Board Posts, and Let Me Know When a Shift I Can Work has been added to the trade board. Note that employees will not be notified of all shifts added to the trade board, but will only be notified of shifts they can work, that is, shifts associated with the positions they're enabled to work. They can also request notifications whenever another employee accepts their trade or pickup shift offer, or requests a trade or pick up their own shifts. They can also be notified when the schedule is published or when a schedule reminder is sent to them, when a schedule is unpublished, when their own published shifts are changed. Note that this notification will not send them messages when someone else's shift is edited, but only when their own published shifts are edited. They might also choose to be notified when their trade or pickup offer has been approved or denied, or when their time off request is approved or denied. Also, if a manager were to spontaneously create or change a time off, or whenever a manager sends out an urgent text alert, just as in the manager account, they click save and the notifications will take effect. When an employee goes to add a text message, it's exactly like the manager accounts. They will also enter their text address. Set up the notifications and click save. They will receive a validation code, just as in the manager account. If you or your employees are setting up a text address and not receiving the validation code, note that the codes are sent instantly. And while sometimes a provider might introduce a delay, it is most likely that the text address you've entered is incorrect. So please go ahead and once again send a text message to an email address to confirm that text address. Back in your manager interface, you can see which notifications your employees have set up. Go to the Employees section and use the Notifications tab. Here, you'll see a check mark wherever your employee has set up a particular notification. If you like, you can check off the notification yourself to make sure that all of your employees are receiving the notification. The highlighted boxes mean that the changes have not been saved. Click Save and they'll take effect. Note that text message addresses are not shown in this grid, in that managers are not enabled to select which text notifications employees will receive. That is because while WhenToWork does not charge for text messages, many cell phone providers will charge employees by the text message. And therefore, employees are required to manage their own text notification setups.